إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، إمام المرسلين وخاتم النبيين وصفته من الخلق أجمعين، سيدي سادات العرب والعجم، فخر ربيع ومضر. فيا أيها الراجون شفاعته أكثروا من الصلاة عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. تدت عين بنظر، وعت أذن بخبر، وقطرت السماء بمطر، وتنفس كل حاقد والقهر. ربي اشرح صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one we ask help, mercy, forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bad deeds of ourselves and the evil of our souls. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided will never be misguided. But whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguide, leave them to be astray, abandon them, leave them to be in charge of their own self and soul, they will never ever be guided. They are in a serious trouble. I bear witness there is no Lord or deity worthy of worship except Allah, the Creator, the one and only one, and Muhammad, peace be upon him, his servant, his messenger, the best and purest of Allah's creation, the face of glad tidings, the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As to follow, my dear brothers and sisters, dear believers, the best greetings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you and upon all the bright faces that came to make sujood, to prostrate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one and only one deserving of your beautiful face, to put in the ground in prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to all the sincere hearts that finds comfort, happiness, satisfaction, content, trust, success with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Success with Hadha al-Azim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest of all, where there is absolutely no success in this dunya, no success in the grave, Qabristan, no success in the hereafter, except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, genuine organic success. Today's khutbah, my dear brothers and sisters, and I always believe, رَبَّ مُسْتَمِعٌ خَيْرٌ مُمَتَكَلِّمٌ, might be a listener better than a speaker. Today's reminder to do with family issues, with social issues, with real matters that really matter in our community, in your house. And this is a very hot topic. Please allow me to land few terrible news on your heart. Prepare your heart. Today's khutbah, it is not a smooth sailing. It is full of turbulence, full of earthquakes and tsunamis. I want to start this khutbah by telling you it's a million times better to be single than being with the wrong person. مليون مرة أفضل أنك تكون عزوبي أفضل مما أنك تكون مع الشخص الغير مناسب أو لإنسانة الغير مناسبة. So therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pinpointed the reality to do with marriage in the Holy Quran and the purpose of marriage by saying وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةَ وَرَحْمَةَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of all, said and pinpointed this reality in the Holy Quran by saying from his signs that he created for you, from you, mates. Mate means wives. So you may dwell in tranquility, and Allah caused among you mawaddata wa rahma, tenderness and mercy. So if we go at the beginning of the verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us that marriage, it is an ayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is one of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the purpose of marriage? It will come later. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that created for you, from you. Where is the lady? Where's the wife created from? Where's the female created from? Is she created from the fist so you could punch her? No. Is she created from the foot so you could give her sidekick? No. She's created from al-dhil. Al-dhil means the rib. Where's the rib? The rib is next to the heart. Precision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next to the heart so you could love her, protect her, take good care of her. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm showing you and me the purpose of the marriage. It's not just marriage certificate. No, it's not just to show, look at my nice looking husband, look at my wife, we are eating here and there. No, the purpose of the marriage, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا, so you may dwell in tranquility. سَكِينَة, not سِكِينَة. سِكِينَة means knife.
Sakina, peace in the mind, peace in the heart. Sounds the same. Sakina, sakina. Sakina is a knife to shatter your comfort and your tranquility. But sakina, it is the peace in the mind, peace in the heart. This is the purpose of the marriage. This is the purpose of this union. The headquarter of your happiness, it is this union. Marriage, it is at home. If you are a billionaire and you are not happy at home, you can't face outside home. You can't face the turbulence and the challenges outside home if you are not happy at home. So therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, وَجَعْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةَ وَرَحْمَةَ. Once you say, I do accept, once you say, نَعَمْ قَبِلْتَ, Allah will inject in the hearts مَوَدَّةَ وَرَحْمَةَ, tenderness, love and mercy. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, these issues, it's a serious matter, because often in our community, I've been in Toronto approximately 40 years, 40. And I could tell you, we wear social masks. We pretend that we are fine. We are okay. Oh, are you Ahmed Shihab? I said, yes, I am. I recognize you from your voice. You're the friend of my father. I said, yes, who's your father? He said, so-and-so, yes, I love your father, good man. How is he? I don't know. Why? I don't talk to him. What do you mean you don't talk to him? He divorced my mom. Okay, let me invite you and your dad for dinner, islah dhat al-bayn, so we could fix the relation and mend the relation, bridge the relation. Let me invite you and your dad for a dinner. No! I said, Allah said in the Holy Quran, وَقَضَ رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, means your Lord decreed that you worship none but Allah and kindness with parents. Allah did not say then. Allah said and. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ, did not say ثُمَّ. Allah said wa. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, right away kindness with parents. Kindness to parents, it is attached. You could never detach it from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greatest purpose of the creation, it is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This great humongous purpose, it is hooked shoulder by shoulder with kindness to parents. No. I said, let me invite you and your dad. نعزمك على العشاء انت والوالد نصلحكم. لا. Get ready. I'm going to land the first bad news on your heart, brothers and sisters. قال, قلت له بر الوالدين. قال, انا بري بابوي, بري بابوي. اذا بشوفه بالشارع اني ما اضربه. بري بأبوي, إذا بشوفه بالشارع إني ما أضربه. He said, my kindness to my father, that if I see him in the street, I don't beat him up. What a great loser. May Allah guide him. May Allah guide us. So therefore, when the husband and wife, they fight, often, most likely, the vast majority of the husband and wife fighting, they have a mug in their hand. Mug, kasa. Kubaya, they have a mug, they have a cup in their hand. The mom and the dad, they fight with the cup. And the first thing get broken, it's the cups. And that is the children. They use the children like a cup to fight with each other. And they don't know the first terrible casualties, the children. The first collateral damage and ripple effect, it is the children. So be careful. Because if your son says, if I see my father in the street, my kindness to him, not to beat him up, wallah, you're not going to have a good son thinking that, oh, he's to my side. He will grow as a good son, as a good supporter. Wallahi, he will grow as a big loser. Trust me, I am almost 60 years old. تقريباً عمري 60 سنة. تبارك الله. وأنا جد, I'm a grandfather 16 years ago. And I could tell you, and mashallah, tabarakallah, I'm a father of 8 children. I could tell you, if you have a son who will fight the mom, he will one day fight you terribly. And if you have a son who fight the dad, he will never be kind to the mom. He will go to other things like drugs and other things. Because to fight mom or dad or both, you are guaranteed a cursed life. And I could sign this and seal it and give it to you. May Allah forbid. So therefore, never encourage your children to fight dad. Never encourage your children to fight mom. Why? Because you are the first loser. You are the first who will suffer and cry blood. You will not cry regular tears. You will cry blood. When you have a son or a daughter being a rebel to their mom or a rebel متمردين against their dad or mom. Respected brothers and sisters, with respect to you, and I always look at you and I say, رب مستمع خير متكلم, might be a listener better than a speaker, but I have been in Toronto almost 40 years, and for the last at least perhaps 30 some years, digging deep into the family's issues. I don't call for it, I get invited to it. So be careful. Fix your headquarter of tranquility. Fix that headquarter of Sakina so you could prosper, so you could have tranquility, serenity, prosperity, and much more. Respected brothers and sisters, please allow me to tell you the second terrible story. Get your heart ready. I'm not here today to tell you that the banana tastes good outside. No. I'm here to tell you that we are living a life that would really make you banana. Really. Will fry your brain. Sheikh, I want you to come to help fix between a husband and wife. This is a call I received from a person I know. I said, okay, I will come. Well, who are they? Do they speak English, Arabic, something? He says they speak both. Okay, I will come. What time? Usually I don't like to come to people's home. We have offices. Come to the office. Bring them to the offices. No, we can't. I said, I don't like to go to their home, or to anyone's home, for marriage counseling. They come to our offices. No. I said, fine. What time? He said, so and so time. Fine. خلاص, done deal. Soon, few just hours later, Sheikh, come now. What? Come now. And he's shouting at me. He's a friend, it's okay. Shout at me, no problem. I felt there's something wrong. Come now. I felt there's something wrong. I arrived there. To my surprise, to see the family I never spoke with and I never met, to see a police yellow strip, and I see a body in the ground, in the grass, covered body. What happened? He killed his wife. He killed her sister. And he committed, I don't want to tell you the word, he jumped from the 18th floor. He lived here. He lived here. How did he die? He lived here. But he went to the 18th floor. I buried them all. All of them I buried with my own hand. And with the government of Canada, and from the bottom of my heart, no cheap talk, no cosmetic talk. May Allah protect Canada. Keep Canada with safety, serenity, prosperity, tranquility. Allahumma ameen. Canada's government sent 3 cars for everybody. And I was number 4 as a volunteer mutatawwa. And I look each car going to the highway. And I said, maybe they needed half an hour, somebody to talk to them. Maybe half a day, half a month. Maybe they needed 1 month, somebody to extinguish the fire better than this result. Leaving a child, not even 1 year old, and all the 3 dead. I said, subhanallah. What happened? Look what happened. He slapped his wife. He slapped his wife. This is what I found later. Brothers, when you snap, don't slap. Remember, when you snap, do not slap. He slapped his wife. She called 911 instead of calling one, Allah, or calling two members of the family, or calling 3 or whatever. She called 911. That's her right. Anyway, 911 came, kicked him out, gave him 2 charges. Just a few days later, I found that her own brother told me, the deceased, the victim brother told me, he's my friend. He came and hugged me and he said, I'm going to go upstairs, talk to your sister. And I looked at the police report myself. It looks like just in a snap. In a snap, everything happened. He did not go there to fight. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, realize that small fire, just tiny fire, leave it in a couch, come soon, in half an hour, you'll find the whole building on fire. Don't leave a small fire, social fire, marriage fire at your house. Try to extinguish it as soon as possible, because the first victims
your heart, your children, and much more. So this is a reality we are living, but we are pretending we are fine. How are you? Great! Having a good day. I just came from Costa Rica. And you'll find him, he just came from a garage sale. How are you? Oh, I'm doing very well. And he's very miserable. So therefore, we have to stop this social mask and work on fixing the headquarter of our sakina, headquarter of our tranquility, serenity, and prosperity. Dear brothers and sisters, I will continue after the break, inshallah. قول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم فاستغفروا إنه نور السماوات والأرض غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. Ex-wife for someone could become an excellent wife for someone else. Ex-husband for someone could become an excellent husband for someone else. So don't worry, nothing wrong to be an ex. It's an excellent sometimes. Don't commit a crime. Don't snap and slap. No, life doesn't end there. There is life after divorce, a successful divorce, a peaceful divorce. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, if you can maintain your wife with honor or release her with kindness. This is in the Holy Quran, right? It's in the Holy Quran to maintain her with honor or to release her with kindness. Respected brothers and sisters, you know the precious pearl, al-lu'lu' thamin, lu'lu' al-ghali dana, the precious pearl. If you take precious pearl and you take 10 of them and you put them in front of a duck, I don't want to say a pig, كرمكم الله, a duck. What does the duck do with the precious pearls? You know what? We throw them here and there. Why? Isn't it precious? Yes. Does it decrease the value? No. But the duck doesn't know the difference. And sometimes, you are the duck, my brothers. Or sometimes, you are the duck, my sisters, and you have a precious husband, and you throw him here and there. And sometimes the husband is the duck, with respect to all of you. Sometimes the husband is the duck, and he doesn't know how precious his wife, he threw her here and there. It works both ways. Sometimes the husband is abused badly, a great husband, badly abused and beaten up. I have cases where the husband gets beaten up. And sometimes the wife gets abused and pushed around and beaten up. A wonderful wife, like the family who called me to come to their house to extinguish the fire. I said, my brother, tell them I don't come to the house. We have 3 offices, let them come to us. And we'll give them free service. Let them come to us. No, please, no, it's fiery. Fine, I went there, the 10 hours of counseling. The man complaining about his wife. I found the wife nice, respectable. We spent 10 hours, this never happened before, never. From 9 at night till 7 in the morning, never happened before. To find that the man complaining so badly about the wife, who is making salah, good manners, very patient, she knows everything about Allah, she's a hijabi, everything. He's complaining about her. And I dig deep to talk to her privately with the brother who brought me, and to talk to him privately with the brother who brought me, sometimes to talk to them both. I found that he goes and gamble, and he drink and come home drunk, Muslim. And gambling, qimar, al-khamra, gambling and drinking, it has other branches. I don't want to say it, we have children here with us. So this gambler, this drunk husband, this husband who's taken his wife as a punching bag, after 10 hours, I told him, listen, I came as a brother who's in Islam, and as a volunteer, as a mutatawwi', trust me, when we leave, we came by your permission, and we leave by your permission. But trust me, one day, someone will kick the door, arrest you, and they are called police. And I told him this privately, so I don't make the wife a rebel, mutamarrida. You have to say certain things to the husband privately and to the wife privately, certain things. Anyhow, I told him, if you keep this attitude of drinking,
قمار and this and that and beating up your wife. I said to him, this is your life. I'm going to enjoy my kunafa and baklava. I'm going to enjoy my life. I'm not even going to think about you. Right? Your children wants to beat you up. Go live in a qabristan, an Urdu grave. Go live in a qabristan better than living in a house where you're making everyone miserable and everyone wants to kill you. This is a reality. 1 week later, the brother phoned me. He said that this man said, I'm not going to listen to Ahmed Shihab. I said, I don't care. I came fi sabillah. I did not come to enforce anything. I spent 10 hours of my life. Only Allah would reward me. That's fine. Few days later, the brother phoned me. Please, please, tell my wife not to destroy me. He called me from jail. From jail. How? Did the wife call 911? No. He lived in a dead end. And you don't know the brother. I could talk about many stories. You don't know the families. So I'm not here spreading secrets. He lived in a dead end. The neighbor, the non-Muslim neighbor, saw him just pushing the wife, just pushing her, not hitting her, no, just pushing her from the back. He called 911. So my dear brothers and sisters, we have wonderful brothers. They make a great husband. And sometimes we have a terrible female. She does not deserve this husband. And sometimes, wallahi, we have a great wife, a great lady, a wonderful mother, a wonderful believer. She does not deserve this terrible creature called husband. So sometimes it's the other way around. It's the other way around. A brother shook my hand when I entered the masjid, not this masjid. He shook my hand. I almost fall. Wallahi, I'm so strong. He said to me, my wife beat me up. I said, subhanAllah, what's going on? My dear brothers and sisters, the topic is very long. If you want to withdraw from your bank, you have to have a deposit before you withdraw. And don't tell me, oh, I could withdraw on line of credit. Haram, riba, haram. So when you want to withdraw, you have to have a deposit to withdraw. Take money. Same thing, you want kindness from your wife? Deposit kindness, to withdraw kindness. You want kindness from your husband? Deposit kindness in his heart to withdraw kindness. Otherwise, it does not work. My dear brothers and sisters, it does not work. And when you have a man coming to your sister or daughter, when you have a man coming to marry your sister or daughter, look for two things. Rasulullah SAW said, Deenahu wa khulaqah, his manners, right, and his deen. The lady, to look for one. Rasulullah SAW said, فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرْبَتْ يَدَكْ. Look with the one with deen. It doesn't mean deen just she's making salah. No, she's well-mannered as well. What's the use of making salah and she is disrespecting everyone around her? What's the use of making salah and gossiping about everyone day in, day out? So when she has deen, means she has the deen and the manners of the deen. So don't be fooled by a man who has a nice hair and then you bury the whole body and you find that you made a big mistake. Don't be fooled by a lady who has a blue eyes or green eyes and you love her eyes and you marry the whole body and you find she has no ethics, no manners, no respect to the value of the marriage life. Because marrying a lady is different than going to a movie with a lady. It's different than going to a dinner with a lady. When you marry, all the social mask will come down. Real life. So it's a million times better to be single than being with the wrong person. Respected brothers and sisters, some people would say, I am in my marriage, أنا مازل صابر or صابرة because of the children, مشان الأولاد. Many people would say that. I am in this marriage because of the children. In reality, you are destroying the children when the marriage is terrible, so bad, the children will have such a destruction in their heart and mind about marriage, about mom and dad, about ethics, about Islam, that you are better off fixing your marriage or saving whatever left from the mind and heart of your children. Dear brothers and sisters, this is a reality. I don't mean to make you miserable, but the reality is so severe, bitter, مرة، حقيقة مرة، that families living day in day out misery upon misery. Why? I'll tell you why. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى. طه, we have not revealed the Quran upon you so it may cause you anxiety. So when we stay from the teaching of the Quran and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, we live anxiety, pain, no gain, humiliation, degradation, suffocation, elimination, and much more. When we are living away from what protect us and prevent misery and pain and hardship and much more, which is the Holy Quran, teaching of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I'm not bragging here and I'm not exaggerating. I've been in Toronto almost 40 years, 40. And I've seen every case comes to us. Every single case comes to us. I look and I scan the case. Every case comes to us, big, small, whatever it is, because we cut from our deen to patch our dunya. We shortchange our deen. We shortchange our Quran and the teaching of the Quran and the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to patch our dunya. Trust me, my dear brothers and sisters. Trust me. Alhamdulillah that Allah made us among the Muslimin. May Allah make us among the mu'mineen. Wallahi, my dear brothers and sisters. Wallahi, it is a great honor, great mercy, great rahmah, a great status that Allah made you Muslim. I worked with non-Muslim for 24 years. Jews, Christians, you name them. I worked with them 6 days a week, 24 years as a manager. I saw the whole world in that 24 years. And I could tell you, wallahi, no matter what they wear and what they drive, a lot of them, they are super miserable. So Muslims and non-Muslims, I repeat, and I'm speaking in English. I'm not hiding under Arabic. I'm speaking in English. Muslims and non-Muslims, they are living misery when they are away from the teaching of the Holy Quran. I ended with two verses from the Holy Quran. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whoever turns away from my remembrance, means the Holy Quran, he, and that means she, shall have a hardship type of a life. مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ, hard life. And the second verse, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانِ فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينِ. Whoever lives away from the remembrance of the most merciful, means the Holy Quran, we shall appoint for him, and that means her, a shaitan, a devil, فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينِ. The devil becomes your companion. May Allah keep loving you, inject in your house, in your hearts, inject مَوَدَّةَ وَرَحْمَةَ. Brothers and sisters, take care of your house. No power on earth can prove me wrong. Take care of your house by taking care of the house of Allah. The masjid. Take care of the masjid. Allah will take care of your house. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت. وعافنا في من عافيت. شافي مرضانا. اهدي ذريتنا حين حياة طيبة. انصر اخوانا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم يا الله, you love forgiveness. اللهم grant us your forgiveness. اللهم guide our children. Heal our loved ones. Allahumma heal our ill ones. Allahumma grant us the good life you promised the Holy Quran. Ya Rabbal Alameen, unite us with our loved ones in paradise. Make our brothers and sisters victorious wherever they are oppressed. Allahumma unite us with their shuhada, martyrs in paradise without any previous punishment. Ameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Salaam Sayyidina Muhammad. Respected brothers and sisters. Qumu salatukum wa rahmukum Allah.